If you are wondering how to make a fully generated AI video, look no further. I will show you exactly what tools I used and how you can get the same results like mine, which can be seen at the end of this video. Let's start with first things first. For a good video, you need a script, characters, scenes, moving heads, and some voices, right? So here's the list of tools that I used, and let me show you exactly how I used each one of them, and then I will show you how they work. First one is ChatGPT for ideas, scripts, conversations, and scene write-ups. Then we used Midjourney for characters and scene designs, remove.bg for background removal, which is behind our characters, 11 Labs for artificial voices that are the most similar to my characters, and then a combination of Stable Diffusion, Run Diffusion, and Genmo for animation of the images, DID for talking heads, and TweetGen to generate tweets, but this can be done through many different tools as well as the code inspect. And lastly, Cartoon Face. As I'm still not well known, I had to recreate my head with a simpler tool because Midjourney was giving me okayish results, but I really wanted something better. So how did I actually use these tools? From ChatGPT, I needed the ideas and what the actual video is gonna be about. So I first fed a tool with freelancer.com contest that I wanted to participate in and added a prompt for it to create potential directions for my new video. Once I got the creative direction for my video, I instructed the tool to create new and different scenes, conversations and characters, as well as some celebrity cameos. And lastly, I needed a name for my show, so I prompted ChatGPT to give me a number of potential names. This is more of a reference for the video. To get a great name, you need to play around a bit with it and provide feedback to get the desired results, but it shouldn't take long. Thanks to the RPRM tool for ChatGPT, you can open a new thread with RPRM, find the Midjourney prompt generator, and then just copy and paste the adjusted brief and scenes from ChatGPT, which you input straight to Midjourney. Next on my list was Midjourney. Once I actually got my script, scenes and characters, I needed to find real-life images of those mentioned characters because Midjourney will not create a good-looking image of the mentioned celebrity without the reference image. I will show you just an example and you will need to replicate this setup for all of the characters in your video. For those of you that are new here, Midjourney is a brilliant tool that can produce amazing images just out of plain text. And with every prompt in Midjourney, you start with first adding slash image, then you go and copy the image URL of the desired person, and here for us we have Margot Robbie, and then you paste that link into the prompt. Once that is done, you can use the prompts from RPRM, which is a ChatGPT plugin for prompt creation, or create them yourself. In my case, because my show is set on the island, I will have a very descriptive words, and lastly and most importantly, I need my style and my parameters. I added a very specific style for its reference and an AR of 69, which is a resolution, because I will need this format later for my YouTube video. Make sure to copy it like I did, because just a small mistake and it won't work. Also, I will need my background scenes, so I just reused the previous prompt to create consistency without the URL of Margot. Next thing that we need to do is to remove background from our characters and add the scenes in behind, and this part is super easy. I used Photoshop because I know how to use it and it's a bit easier for me, but you can go to remove.bg if you do not have experience, add the AI generated photo of Margot, wait for the magic to happen, and there you have it. Now you can use her image to paste it on all other backgrounds that you have created, such as the one we created from the same prompt. Next on is a brilliant AI piece which is called 11 Labs. There is a big disclaimer here, I use the voice of Margot solely for educational purposes, but that is her own property and it shouldn't be used. You need to be sure that you have the right to use anyone's image or anyone's voice and have their consent. Now that we got that out of the way, in 11 Labs we go on Add Voice, then Instant Voice Cloning, we name it, describe it and give it a few prompts that so the tool can understand how it should sound like, and then generate. Once we click Generate, we have our new voice. We click Use and you will see that you have a couple of voice settings like speed, clarity, or how similar or different it is going to be. And lastly and most importantly, in the text box, we add the text which actually needs to be created. For image animation, I started with Stable Diffusion first and its online variation called Run Diffusion, but realized that I will need too much time to do it, so I found a much simpler solution called Genmo. I will soon create a separate tutorials on both Stable Diffusion and Run Diffusion, but for now let's stick to Genmo. Genmo is actually short for generation plus motion, and it's a tool that generates video from text. With the help of this tool, we generated all the movements in the scenes we generated using Midjourney in our previous steps. There are three options in Genmo for creating the first frame or seed: search, create, and upload. We used upload, where we uploaded the scenes that were previously generated. We also need to adjust the options. How long do we want the video to be? How drastic changes do we want? How fast should the scene change? And how smooth do we want the transition between the frames? Some of our guidelines were that we didn't want to change the scene too much, so we kept exploration around 30 and dynamism around 17 to 20. After that, it takes about 3 minutes for the tool to generate the entire video for us so that we can decide if it's good enough or if we want to generate it again with different parameters. Now that we have our scenes, characters, and voices, we actually go in DID and give it a life. We go on to create video, add to add our new presenter, and here you can do it directly with the background that you created earlier, then you upload a voice audio, upload your own voice, and once that is done, you simply generate your video. How brilliant and easy is that? And lastly, a couple of very easy generators. TweetGen to create tweets that are similar or same like mine. Starburst generators to create similar looking text, but different fonts and music because of the IP, of course. And then Face Cartoon or similar apps to create faces out of images as cartoons. That's only in case that Midjourney isn't providing you with correct solutions. So let me show you our final result here. And if this was helpful, like, share, subscribe, and see you in the next one.